Hey guys, JC Max here with another fix, and today I'm going to teach you how to fix your reverse parking sensor speakers if it's not functioning correctly. And we're going to be doing that by replacing the rear parking sensor speaker, which is located in the rear shelf. This rear parking sensor speaker provides a lower pitch tone to the driver, which assists them in detecting certain objects while the car is in reverse. Or if the vehicle is in reverse but not moving, and a moving object is approaching the rear of the vehicle at a speed of 3 miles per hour or less, you will hear an audible tone because of this speaker. The problem is, this tiny speaker tends to get worn out through time, and eventually it will need to be replaced. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to replace it at home very easily. All of you guys at home will be able to replace it without a problem after watching this video. First, let's get our safety cool shades on so nothing gets into our eyes. And all you're going to need is just common household tools. And these are very simple tools that are very easy to use that you can find within my Amazon affiliate links that you'll see within the description below. And I have the perfect example on how to do this with this Lincoln MKS. Let me show you. To test the rear parking sensor, you'll see that I'm already close to the curb. And since I'm close to the curb, all that I need to do to check if the rear sensor speaker is working is just go ahead and start the car, place the car in reverse, and get even closer to the edge. And as you can see, I'm getting closer to the edge, and there is no sound coming from the rear parking sensor speaker. I'm getting closer and closer, and it doesn't state if it's on or off. All it says is check rear park aid. So that lets me know that the speaker is bad. Well, I have my trusty scan tool here from Autel, which will help me further diagnose exactly what this message means. Let's go ahead and plug in our Bluetooth dongle from our Autel into the OBD2 port. After a quick scan with my trusty Scotty Kilmer scan tool that only certain trusted mechanics could use, let's go ahead and scan the error codes. And after a quick scan, we're already showing that there is a fault in the parking aid module. Let's go ahead and click it and see exactly what it's referring to. So we know that we didn't hear any sound within the rear parking aid, so let's go ahead and quickly pick rear parking aid. Read codes. So audibly it's showing that there is sound coming from the front. And there we go. After a quick test, it shows that we have a C1742 code, which stands for rear sounder circuit failure. All right, so being that I have the speaker, let's go ahead and fix it. So now you have a pretty good idea of the symptoms of a faulty rear sensor speaker. So where is this rear speaker located? Well, it's actually pretty easy to find. It will actually be right here in the rear parcel shelf. So in order to get to that point, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take off this rear cushion here, take off some of this trim panel, remove this back portion of the seat, take off the rear shelf, and ultimately remove the two retaining clips that houses it within the rear parcel shelf. So, if your car is more modern, like this 2009 Lincoln MKS, odds are you'll have a rear sensing speaker that will allow you to hear the tone when objects appear. All right, now that you know how it works, let's go and replace it. First, we're gonna need to remove this negative terminal off the battery, as the rear doors will be open for a considerable amount of time. So what we're gonna use is just an 8mm wrench to remove this negative terminal. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. Oh man, there goes Butch. I don't know. Is he gonna come and bother me today? Wow, Butch is such a nice guy. He's picking up litter. Now that is a cool dude. Butch in the wild. How you doing today, Butch?
JC, how you doing?
I'm blessed. Nice to see you again.
How are
you? I'm blessed. Well, he's not such a nice guy after all. Because what did he end up doing? He threw the litter that he picked up into the back of the bed of that Silverado.
Oh, Butch. You see, Butch, I was rooting for you, brother. So what should I do? Should I go remove the trash that Butch put into the back of that Chevrolet Silverado? Nah.
All right, from under the front of the cushion assembly, I need to push the two cushion floor latches release levers towards the driver's side. So let's go ahead and get our fingers under here, and there we go. Go ahead and push it towards the driver's side and lift up just like that. So we're gonna do the same thing to the other side. Let's go ahead and do it. Driver's side, push up just like that. Now we need to push the cushion assembly back as far as possible. And then from there, we'll lift up and pull out the rear outboard ends of the cushion assembly. Just like this. Push up, push back, pull up. All right, you see that? And from here, you'll see that there are some retaining hooks that you need to disengage. So let's go ahead and do that. So what we'll do is push back as far as possible and then lift up, just like that. Now let's do the same to the other side. All right, so now we'll be able to pull the seat cushion up. But before we move it up all the way, let's go ahead and remove the heated seat electrical connection. And it's located right here. So all we're going to do is push down and pull out, just like that. So now we're able to fully remove the bottom seat cushion. Now we can go ahead and store it. Now after the seat cushion heater mat electrical connector is disengaged, now it's time to disconnect the heated seat electrical connection right here. So just go ahead and push in and pull out. And now we need to pull the safety belts out through the slots of the left hand and the right hand safety belt guides. Let's do it. Go ahead and set that aside. And now it's time to remove the two backrest mounting bolts. In order to remove them, we're gonna be using a 15 millimeter socket. So there's one right here and one right there. And don't worry guys, I'll make sure to include all torque specs within the captions above for proper reinstallation. Let's go ahead and do the other side. Let's go ahead and store them. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and slide the backrest up, which will disengage the three backrest frame upper retainers from the package tray sheet metal. They will be located right here, and right over there. So let's go ahead and slide this backrest up. All right, let's go ahead and go to the other side. Same thing on this side. Pull up and out. So now let's go ahead and pull it all the way up. Let's do the same thing on the other side. So pull up just like that. Now let's remove the seat belts. Next, we'll position the rear door weather strip seal aside. Next, remove the rear door scuff plate. And work your way all the way up. Set it aside. Now it's time to remove the C-pillar trim panel. We'll be doing that with the 7 millimeter socket right here. Now pull the trim towards the seat to detach the clips. easy peasy. Now, after the lower and the upper C-pillar trim panels are removed, now it's time to remove the partial shelf pin type retainers. With our trim panel remove tool, we're just gonna go ahead and push in and push, just like that. We're gonna do it to all three. Now it's time to disconnect the rear speaker electrical connector. Go ahead and push in and pull out. All right, and let's go ahead and remove our seatbelt. All right, the instructions state to remove the entire partial shelf, but that's really not necessary because the speaker is right there in the middle. So instead of removing the whole thing, we'll just go ahead and lift up and remove the speaker just like that. And for those wanting to know where the rear parking aid module is located on this 2009 Lincoln MKS, it's located right here. All you would do is just remove these two push pins right there. And then from there, you remove this module. It's very easy. So there it is for the parking aid module for reference. But what we're actually looking for is the rear parking aid speaker, which is right here. Now that we've located our rear parking aid sensor speaker, there are two push pins that are keeping it connected to the partial shelf. So once the trim panel remover is there, all we're gonna do is go ahead and push down on it. And that disengages it right there. That's one side. And we'll do the same thing to the other side. And let's do the other side as well. Push down. Now it's removed. Okay, and we'll remove this electrical connector, stick it in there, and then pulling out. And for those interested in the part number, this is genuine Ford part 4L1Z-15K864-A, made in Mexico. And let's go ahead and compare. This is before and after. And as you can tell here, you can see inside, it's brown and pretty much foggy inside. And the new one, there's no brown inside of it at all. So definitely, with the date stamp of 2008 right there in August, we have 2014 here. It's been a while. So now it's time to replace it. So the first thing we need to do is just go ahead and push these pins out and place them on here. And that's it, guys. Now it's time to reinstall it. Just like that. So now, before reinstalling anything, I'm gonna go ahead and start the car and place it in reverse and see if we have any sound. Let's do it. All right, here's the moment of truth. Let's go ahead and start the engine. Let's go ahead and place it in reverse. Rear park aid on. So now the angle brackets are on the on symbol. Before it was not. So let's go ahead and reverse and let's see if we can get closer to the curb and if we can hear the sound. Let's do it. And there you have it, guys. That's the sound of the rear parking aid speaker. It is working. Success. We did it. Now we did not have to waste money at the dealership. We were able to do it by ourselves for no cost at all, only for the speaker and for the parts that we use, which are common household tools. All right, guys, thank you for joining me. Once again, I will leave those torque specs with the captions within the video for reinstallation. All we're going to do is just do everything in reverse order the same way we took it off. Have a blessed day, guys. Bonus. I'm blessed. The funny thing about that occurrence was the fact that the Chevrolet Silverado is right there, yet the trash can that I'm always throwing my trash out is right there. He picked it up at the trash can. Why would you do that, Bush? Why?